What is up, everybody, and welcome back to a new episode of FTB Sky Factory 3. Now, today, we are going to be starting episode 11, I believe this is. Should be a lot of fun, and today we've got some awesome stuff to get going. First of all, big change. It's a little bit bigger. I've added three floors to it. Now, this first floor is just normal as it was. It's a lot bigger than it was. We've got a second floor, which is, again, normal. Now, the third floor, the hole where the mobs fall down to come down to here, it's got witch water in it, so we do get some wither skeletons spawning. And obviously, they've been dropping some good stuff. These I got from a loot bag, but these is what they drop. Wither dust, which is pretty cool. I've also got some drops of evil, which means we can make some cursed earth and stuff, which is awesome. But anyway, as you can see, I have some loot bags in my inventory. Now, I've been crafting all the loot bags I've got from this baby into legendary loot bags. And we're going to open a few on camera now. So let's first open this Dark 20 bag. I have no clue what it is. Should be interesting. It's a bunch of stone and some glass, which is kind of useful, I guess. So we're going to run back to the base and deposit that stuff. And that should be pretty cool, I guess. So yeah, I'm also going to make a barrel while I'm at it. So that would be... There we go. Should be enough for a barrel. Let's make a chest. I mean, not a barrel, a storage drawer. It's almost the same thing. And there we go. So I want to put this guy up. Let's just put him. Don't know if we'll be able to use this chest. We can. Brilliant. Stone can all go in there. Glass can go there. That stone can come out and go there. Brilliant. Now we're going to open these legendary bags. And we've got a golden apple. It's pretty useful. An optatic upgrade. Very useful. We'll put that in this guy. And we also got some diamond horse armor, which is, I guess, pretty good. Let's get rid of that. This one, mana pearl, nice. Chance ice, cohedron. We're not going to use that yet. Diamond helmet, magic bean, and manulin. Beautiful. The diamond helmet, chuck instantly in there, well, with the diamond armor, and that will get, you know, chucked up. That obviously can't be put in there, which is cool, I guess. It can go in there. Magic bean can go away. It can't go in there. That sucks ass. That can't, none of that, no. Okay, right. So, as you can see, we're having a bit of storage problems, which is not the best, but there we go. Things happen. Right, let's get rid of this. So, what I wanted to do today, as you can see, I've got some stuff up here, and first of all, I wanted to make myself, I wanted to make myself a storage drawer controller. So, let's get one of them. Let's get ourselves some comparators. I need to be on the crafting table so I can make that guy. Okay, so we need some stone. And I chucked away my sticks, didn't I? I had this all planned out. I had all, just enough resources for everything. But things change, I guess. Things change. Give me just... No. You absolute poo. That'll be fine. Let's get rid of you. Okay, right. So let's go and make ourselves some torches. We need 6 of these guys. Beautiful. Let's go and make comparators when the stuff gets back in. Nope, you're not going to magnetate towards me. Of course you're not. Okay, 2 repeaters, and then let's make ourselves... I had a basic drawer, but obviously it got... I've placed it somewhere, probably. Of course I did. That's classy. Right, let's do that. There we go. Boom, boom, and boom. Really, chest? You had to do that, didn't you? Of course you did, because Minecraft just doesn't like me. There we go, and there is the drawer controller. Okay, the next thing I wanted to make is I made loads of storage upgrades. I'll show you what they did. Well, actually, I got them out of loot bags, some of them. Some of them I made. I made 5 emerald ones, so I used... No. I made 8 emerald upgrades. I used all my emeralds that I had, 32 of them. But there we go. Right, so I wanted to make this guy, the mob masher. Now, this is some blocks of iron, some iron spikes, and some diamond spikes. It's expensive, but it's going to be worth it. So what we're going to want is 3 diamond swords. Beautiful. Then we're going to want to do this. No, not you. We're going to want to go like that. We're going to want a diamond block, naturally. And then we're going to want to go like this. And we're going to want 1 more diamond. I clearly didn't plan this out the best. 1 more diamond. It's right with a bunch of diamonds, so I'm fine with doing this. And this is way worth it, so it's good. Okay, and we also want to make some iron spikes. They are made, again, kind of the same recipe, just with iron. Hence the iron spikes, of course. Let's get this and go boom, boom, boom. That'll be good. Thank you, iron, for being an absolute piece of turd. There we go. Make yourself properly, you poo. And again, get 4 from that. Beautiful. And then the last thing we want to do is make ourselves some plain blocks of iron. We're going to need to make the thing you saw there. Not just enough iron for that. Good. And then we're going to want this guy. So 4 more torches. I really don't know why random things just jump in the crafting table. Of course, the wood I had planned as I've freaked it away, obviously, to try and clean my inventory out. And there is a redstone gear. Brilliant. So now we can go like this and make ourselves a mob masher. Beautiful. We're now going to need a lever or some kind of redstone thing. We're going to use a lever because pretty easy. Pretty easy. There we go. A lever. So this thing is absolutely amazing. It can be upgraded to do different stuff, to hold different stuff, to just be more amazing, to get you more loot, etc, etc, etc. It's pretty darn awesome. So how we're going to make it is we're going to want to do some kind of upgrading stuff here. So what we're going to do is we're going to get ourselves our fast vector plates out. We're going to break this wall up. We might get some mobs falling down on us, but that'll be fine. We can cope with a few of them, I would imagine, hopefully. Maybe, possibly, probably not. It's fine. Okay, I wanted to also... Oh, I made this between episodes as well. Rod of the Shifting Crust. Now, what this does is it will transmutate blocks, which is extremely cool. It will obviously, you know, change whatever block type you want. So, for instance... Oh, you're going to die there. Brilliant. And, of course, I died. But, yeah, this one of the Shifting Crust will, you know, transmutate any block to the block that you specified you want it to transmutate to. Holy crap, that's a lot of mobs. This was not the best idea. Give me a sec. Okay, so, yeah, as I was saying, transmute any block. But, first of all, let's just have a look at this. Look, I have so much stuff. It's insane. Anyway, so this is set to chiseled stone. It's set to that type of chiseled stone. So, if we make that beautiful, and then we should just be able to go like this. Boom. You're gonna work for me. Naturally, you're not. Of course, you're not. Beautiful. You need my mana tablet, and that has no mana in it. Of course, it doesn't. So we're not gonna use this guy. We're just gonna do it ourselves. I died quite a few times making this. I'll call that because it's like light. Good. Yeah, I died quite a few times making this, like on the platform, generally because mobs killed me. Like pretty much just what happened there. And I obviously. Lost my mana tablet, and for some reason it didn't spawn back in. I don't know why. So, yeah, I don't have any mana left, which is fine. So, what we want to do is we want to put the... I'm afraid you're going to have to die, skeleton. You're very irritating. There we go. Let's get rid of these plungy sticks. So, yeah, we're going to want to place this mob masher guy about here. So, we're going to want to place some of these back, I would think. Let's get them out of there. So, let's place... How do we have these in the middle, I take it. So let's put these kind of back there. I don't know if we can place the mob masher directly there. I'm hoping we can, but I don't know. So let's have a look. If this kills us, it will be hilarious, but I don't think it will. We can place it there. Beautiful. And that is pretty much it. So what we want to do is, let's just go through here. That thing will hurt you when it's not on, which is kind of odd. But there we go. We want to then get ourselves our fast vector plates. And holding shift, you won't, these power vector plates won't affect you. These are the fast ones, which are now, they now require wither dust to make that wither powdery stuff. So they're way more difficult to make than before. So yeah, just like a little bit of information there. They're a bit more difficult to make. But there we go. That is pretty much it. Now, what I'm going to do, though, is I am going to put some punchy sticks. I might put iron spike. Oh, crap. Right, you're going to have to die, spider, as well. I'm very sorry. Naturally, you're my friend, but you're going to have to die. So why don't we use the rest of our spikes we've got and just put them back up there. I might use punji sticks, actually. And this thing is going to end up killing me, isn't it? Naturally, it is. Right, so let's just get our punji sticks back. The reason why I'm putting these guys still here is because... How do you even allow things to go on the front of you? You weird thing. Punji sticks there, so it still kills spiders. Because they will be a pain. So there we go, and put a punch stick back there. Witch water I made, by the way, you put mycelium. You can use those really old ancient spore things and put it on dirt and it'll turn to mycelium. Then you put a barrel on top of mycelium with water in it, it'll turn to witch water. Pretty useful. So, if we put that there quickly, and I just demonstrate this by doing this, you'll see that guy will turn on. So now, if we put this back here, and yeah, that will now kill mobs very efficiently. So give me 2 secs, I'll be right back. And for some reason, oh, because I'm so near, mobs aren't spawning. But there we go. We have got some mobs coming through. And as you can see, that thing is just going to munch on them and kill them pretty much. Pretty cool. I think it's nice. It's a lot better than the punch sticks. I don't know if it's better straight away, but you can upgrade it, which is why I like it. We've got a another direwolf 20 bag, which is mildly hilarious. I am going to get rid of you. I do not want you. Now, what I wanted to also do with this draw controller is we can get rid of all of these. And you may think, what am I doing? This is mad. But, you will understand my madness in a second. So let's just put that guy back. Let's get rid of all of you. And then what we're going to do is we're going to get the draw controller guy and put that here. And now this guy will allow me to interact with everything with one click. So for instance, if I take just a bunch of random crap out, if I just go, all of it goes. We can go in there. So now this guy can interact with every single one of them, but obviously extremely, well, a lot more easily. So yeah, pretty cool. I've also got a loot bag opener. You can put loot bags in here and it will open them inside the inventories if you don't have enough inventory space. And I've got a loot bag recycler. So you chuck random stuff that you get from loot bags in there that you don't want, and it will turn them into a magic stored loot stuff, which you can exchange for loot bags. Pretty darn cool. So now, if we go over to here, you can see all my deaths. Let's get rid of them. Map. Beautiful. And let's go remove. Okay, so now if we go all the way over here, you can see mobs are going to start spawning again. And if I just take a quick nap, sleepy, we can go over to my lovely bit of land over here, my lovely real estate, and just watch the mobs die. Because I have that lovely dark glass installed, and you can just watch them die. There we go. Beautiful. Pretty cool. So that what that witch water will do at the in the top level, it's only in the top one, will turn skeletons that fall into it into wither skeletons and creepers into charged creepers, etc. So it just means I can get some drops from wither skeletons. That mob crushery thing, I think, acts as a player, which is really awesome. So it will kill, things and drop player upgrades to them, which is really flipping awesome. But we do want to get some upgrades to them. We do want to get some upgrades. So what we're going to do is we're going to look at what upgrades we can get and then what upgrades we can stick in, of course. So what we're going to want immediately is looting and probably sharpness, because that thing, as you probably saw there, is a pretty darn slow. We might want beheading later on as well. So let's have a look at, for instance, sharpness. And to get one of these, you're going to have a maximum of 10. It takes an iron sword, some blocks of redstone, and some gold nuggets. So if we wanted to make 10 of these, it would cost us 40 gold nuggets, 40 blocks of redstone, and 40 iron swords, which would be 40, 80, 120 iron. We have enough. Beautiful. There is 120 iron. Like so. Do we have some spare sticks in here? We do. We're going to go through a lot of them. This is going to take up a lot of inventory space to craft as well, which is fine, because we have a massively stacked inventory. So let's get also some redstone. I don't know if we'll have enough to make 10 blocks of redstone. I reckon we will. But what's that's to make sharpness? I think I'd rather make looting first. So let's, in fact, actually, first of all, put back the iron. Let's put these sticks back in here for a minute. And let's see what the looting one takes. I think that'll be more, better. The looting will be a better upgrade to get than the other one. So that takes some lapis, some gold nuggets, and some blocks of redstone. So that's going to take 4 lapis for each one. We're going to want 10 of them, so 40 lapis. That's not bad. I can easily make that. So let's go 8. Beautiful. Let's also grab, 10 blocks of redstone. Should be pretty easy to do. So 10 blocks of redstone. That is 5 of them, and that is another 7. Beautiful. Enough redstone. Let's lob this back into there. And let's also get ourselves 40 gold nuggets. So we're going to need a little bit of gold. So let's just take all of that. That will be way enough. And there we go. And let's make ourselves some looting upgrades. Beautiful. 10 of them, which should be really useful. Now, if we go over to our mob mashery machine Madood Hickey, which of course is at the moment running and smashing all these mobs. We're going to wait. We're just going to watch them die for a bit. We want to wait till they're all dead. Also, this does kill bats, which is extremely useful. And the chest is full, I would suppose. It is very full. I would not know why that is. I do know why that is, actually. Let me run, fix that. I was going to say another word, but I couldn't think of it. It didn't come to my head. So, the Yetta Wrench. Beautiful. You are here. I do need to get down there. A bit risky. What are we going to do? How are we going to do this? I would love to be able to look at you right now. Jesus, how's this going to work? Can I, force a thing on you? That's not what I wanted to do at all. Can I force a connection for you? I cannot. It doesn't look like I can, which is absolutely brilliant. So what I'm going to do then for the moment, or for the time being, is... I think we lost the draw controller. Beautiful. Right. This could be, this could be exciting, I guess. Where did the draw controller go is my first question. Let me get this. I'll get this fixed. I'll be back in 2 secs. Okay, welcome back. So, if I put my Yetta wrench in there, you can see now all the items are coming flying out. Supposedly flying, of course. And they're going to go straight into these guys. You can see the player drops things are working because we're getting armor. And I think armor is a player drops? I think. I'm thinking. I'm going to disenchant, like, get the enchantments off here if I like them. I'm probably not going to use you. You're pretty useless. I might... I'll keep you just because I can. My Yetta wrench. I want you. You can go back in my rucksack. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. And you, I want to remove you. So you can go just match, meta, match, MBT, match. And you should be normal. Audic. If I ignore Audic, you are a normal filter. Okay. You, I want to do the same. I'll take you out, take you out. Match, meta, match, ignore. You should be a normal filter. And there we go. Saved a little bit of storage space. So there we go. All working. Everything's looking hunky flipping dory. Let's make another chest, I think, for wither dust. So let's do that. Let's grab ourselves some wither dust and that on our inventory bar so we can put it in instantly. So let's go boom, boom. And lovely. What we're going to do is we're going to grab ourselves our keys out of here. The quantify key and the draw key. And that's be beautiful. We're also going to need to add this to wither dust stuff to a filter. So let's get out our Yetta wrench again and grab some wither dust stuff. You know, that's what I call it, wither dust stuff. And it's going to put that on there. And there we go. It should now... That's not what I wanted it at all to do. I didn't know you could do that. That's very fancy. And now it should be extracting that stuff as well and shoving it right into there. Okay. Beautiful. Now, in terms of upgrading our drill thing, which I do want to do, but I want to wait for all of these guys to die first. The only problem is those guys aren't going to die, are they? I'm just going to move the drill. So let's break into here. Let's break that. These guys are going to come charging out. No, no, they're not because they can't move because the conveyors are there, which is absolutely brilliant. So we're going to break you. And you are extremely difficult to break. Painful as hell. And of course, we don't get you back. Oh, yes, you probably do, but you probably got sucked up, which is fine. Oh, thank God you did get sucked up. Thank God, because you were expensive. I'd probably better make another one, but that would not be the point at all. We're going to get some more punji sticks as well, hoping they went into here. They did. Gorgeous. My life is brilliant. I'm going to put these here again for spiders. I would love to not die. I would love to not die for the 500 millionth time. Please do not kill me. Right, so let's break this one. So we have another way to get out. Let's put these back so just we can put a punji stick there. You can go there, and then we can walk out without being killed by the punji sticks. Beautiful. Let's get our spare punji stick back. Our little friend. I mean, not the pillar. You know what I meant. The pillar cobblestone. If we put this lever now here, and beautiful, and it should turn our lovely friend, the mobby juicer guy, back on. I do realize I didn't put the upgrades in it, but there we go. He's running. So now he will kill even the small guys that come in. So if we break this block, okay, and we look down at the mob grind utility, you can see we can put loads of upgrades in. So let's chuck our looting things in there, and now this has looting on it. If we put all 10 in there, it's going to give us some major looting effects. So if we, like, go over here and hope that the mob comes down, we may start getting some really cool stuff from it, potentially. I don't know what all this is. This must have been stuff I've got from my elite bags. I believe it probably is, which is awesome. So I'm going to move all of this crap into there that I don't want with me at the moment. I have a spider head. Delicious, I'm sure. Right, let's get rid of pretty much all the stuff that isn't normal. Your mob loot. You will come with mob loot. You won't, but I'll leave you in there. You will not. I'll move you anyway. You can come out, you can come out, you can come out. That's a good amount for the moment, I think. Beautiful. Let's put the punch sticks in there as well. There we go. Pretty cool. Let's get the bones and everything out of here, because they can actually be sorted. And then I'll lob them back in the storage thing, and they will get sorted away. Bones, end pearl.
Delicious. A lot better of a sorting system, I think. And now that's got some major looting on it, so we should be getting a lot more drops than we already have at the moment. And of course, we do have a ton. There's 72 stacks. We can hold 416. It's got two Enderpearl upgrades. Oh, it's only got one. Forget me. All of these have got one in them. I put one in every single one. So they can hold an absolute ton of stuff, which is brilliant. It helps. So, what I want to do now is, if we have enough stuff left, I would like to make the sharpness upgrades. Because as you can see, that mob mashery, doobie-da-bubba, takes a flipping age to kill things, pretty much, is the main thing. So, yeah. We want to make some sharpness upgrades. So, we're going to need a butt ton of redstone. Again. I don't know if we even have enough to make some enough blocks. I would want to make 10 blocks of redstone again. Oh, we have just a perfect amount. Beautiful. I'm not sure whether I want to see. The other thing we're going to make in this episode is a vacuum hopper. Did I spell that wrong? I did. Vacuum hopper. You are there. You do not take any redstone. Delicious. And then I also want to make a XP, are they called? What are they called? Is it called XP? I hope it's called XP because I can't remember the name of it. An XP vacuum. We can make you, I guess, instead. Yeah, let's make. We might as well just make you an XP vacuum. Yeah, so I don't think we'll make the vacuum mob, we'll make the XP vacuum instead. And then we want to, how are we going to do this? There it is, experience obelisk. Beautiful, you do not require redstone either. Lovely, and then we want to make one more thing. We want to go to tank. And we're going to want to make one of you. Which is easy as jazz to make. So, let's first of all make the sharpness upgrades. So, they are as follows. A bunch of iron swords and some more nuggets, which is not difficult. So we're going to need 40 more nuggets. We do have perfectly enough. Lovely. 40. Okay, we're going to want how many swords? 4 swords for each one. 10 swords, and that's going to be 40 swords, 80 iron. So, 80 iron? I worked out a lot more. I looked at 120 iron last time. What was it? 2 sword, 2, 20, 40, 60, 80. Yeah, only 80. Okay. Let's just make this easier myself. And do that, and then go. Beautiful. 80. Iron. Let's get a bunch of sticks out as well. And let's just make some swords, really. That 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to craft all these. It's going to take a bit of a while. I'll be back in a sec. And the last set of swords. I'm sorry if the audio jumped there. I accidentally clicked the recording off button instead of the recording resume button because I'm a douche. But there we go. The last sharpness upgrade. Beautiful. Okay, so we did make a bit too much. Well, we got a bit too much iron, but that is no problem at all. Now, of course, if we grab... Why do we only have 9? We only have... Oh, okay. We made one extra block of redstone that we didn't need. Good. Oh, yeah. We made 10, didn't we? We only needed 9. That's good. We have a bit more redstone spare. Okay, I am going to need to do a lot of sifting, but that's fine. So, sharpness upgrades. Again, like we did before, we're going to run over to our buddy, the mob destroyery, crashery, doodary thing. And we're going to stick these guys in it. So, sharpness. And that's now going to kill these guys extremely quickly. Delicious. They're going to die like little bums. Which is great, because we're going to get a lot of drops, including necrotic bones. And we should be getting some wither skeleton skulls, but of course for that, we're going to need beheading. Now, we don't have the redstone for that at the moment. And you may be thinking, oh, you're dumb, you don't have the redstone for that. But, I have something we're going to do first. We're going to make a few more items this episode. Should be really cool. Hope you're excited. Grab something to eat. It's going to be a lot of fun. So, the things we're going to need are a fluid tank, which is very basic to make. We're going to need some iron bars. 4 of you. I'm going to need 4 of you. And now I can't remember whether it's planes or... it's just a clear piece of glass. Beautiful. There we go. So, that all crafted together will give us a lovely, beautiful fluid tank. We're also going to need, after that, an XP vacuum and an XP obelisk. We will make the obelisk first because they both require this baby. So, we're going to need 2 experience rods. So that's 4 solarium, 2 energetic alloys. Not anoids. Don't mix the two. So, first of all, I have some witch water left in the barrels over here. Easily created, you know. I have 4. Is that a coincidence? I think not. Let's get 4 sand. And we're going to shove that... sorry for my iPad being off. We're going to put that in there, and that gives you soul sand. If you put sand into witch water, it will give you soul sand, which is amazing because we need exactly 4. Solarium. Again. What's this coincidence? Who knows? But if we do... allies only, and we go boom and boom. That's going to make us some Solarium. Of course, we have our Octadic upgrade in here, so it's going a bit faster than it normally would. I'm just going to turn my ringer off. There we go. Alright, so we're going to get the last bit of Solarium in here, and of course it's going to be auto put into my little chest friend on the edge. By the way, if you smelt down diamonds in a smelter, you get printed advanced processes, which is kind of good, I guess. But there's Solarium. So we're going to need 2 energetic alloy, which we did get some from loot bags, which is great. And then if we do this, this, and this, we get experience rods. Beautiful. So now, if we go to this guy and we want 3 more Solarium, oh dear. What are we going to have to do? We're going to make some more. So let's get some buckets. Let's get 4, even though we need 3. I'm going to put 4 in there. I might as well. Let's go over to our trusty barrels on top of the mycelium and just put the water in there. And you will see it is now transforming. It takes a little bit of time. It's not too long. It's decent. And this will turn into witch water. So let's get ourselves some sand. We're going to need 3 of that. Beautiful. We're also going to have a look at what else this stuff needs. So it needs a machine chassis. Let's make that. Another 4 iron bars. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Another 4 iron. And then a, what is it called? A neurocapacitor. There we go. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And 2 redstone. Good, aren't we lucky we didn't use all the redstone. Let's put that there. The copper there. The golden nuggets like so. And hey presto, there's a capacitor. Let's grab that and do boom, 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 boom. Gorgeous, gorgeous. And there we go. Machine chassis. Now, this guy is made in a similar fashion, but not completely the same. We're going to need 7 of you, my lovely friends. We're going to need a vibrant alloy. Or, I think it's a vibrant alloy? Or is it a... no, it's pulsating iron. Excuse me. So we're going to need a diamond. Pulsating iron is made like so, I'll have you know. It's made with... that's not what I wanted to do. It's made with an enderpearl and iron. Pretty easy with a bunch of enderpearls. This isn't all I have. I have loads in the chest over there, as you probably saw. But iron... an enderpearl. Boom. Boom. We also, by the way, have an enderman infestation on the island because they spawn up in that top chamber, and because it's witch water, they teleport whenever they hit witch water or any water, so they pretty much just always come out here. It's not the best. It's not a fun party with the enderman around, but, you know, we're going to think for a way to kill them soon, so that's absolutely fine. I can live with them for a little bit. They're kind of good company. They keep me company. I'm not going to lie. Got only animals. But there we go. Let's make the... this baby. So, we're going to need some Solarium. So, we're going to want some gold. Some gold, again. 3 gold is going to make us 3 more Solarium. Of course, with the soul sand. Beautiful. It is obviously raining, so our rain shield is doing a lovely little, it's lovely job of making the rain go away, which is good, because I don't like the rain. By the way, these guys are really difficult. Do not try to kill them yourselves. I've only got obsidian armor on, which I got from a loot bag, I have, you know. Same as all these obsidian tools. But, yeah, don't try to take them on. They will kill you. Anyway, let's get some Solarium. And let's then make ourselves the experience obelisk, which you can store experience. I'll show you how to do that when we actually use it. And then we're obviously going to want this guy, but we've made our pulsating iron. It should be made now. Did I not put you in there? I don't think I did that. Yeah, I did. You're right there. I'm obviously blind. Right, let's put a nugget of you in there. Grab the rest of you. Let's go like this. And this will make ourselves a pulsating crystal, which we can then do this with. And there's our XP vacuum. Beautiful. Now, if we take our trusty friends over to our little merb farm. Don't know how you're spawning. You're probably spawning... oh, on top of my mob thing, which is absolutely delicious. I would imagine that's where you're spawning anyway, but of course I could be wrong. You are full up of a lot of junk. So... we're going to need to edit this filter. Very easy to do. Very easy indeed to do. We're going to want to look at this transfer node. Look at this filter. Get this baby out. We're going to want to make sure you do not pull a bunch of crap out. So I'm going to have you up here. And let's add match MBT, match meta, ignore dictionary. I want you to ignore metadata. And you can take in bows. And that should, I think, get rid of all our bows. So we're going to test that out. Put again the transfer node back there like a lovely friend. Transfer pipe, beautiful, and there we go, filter, go for it, transfer me some stuff, you're gonna, oh my, there's a heckler's stuff coming in, why aren't you extracting, you're not doing your job, transfer node, You are really not doing it very well. Oh, you are getting rid of sticks, though. I can see them disappearing slowly. So you are doing something. So let's see if it does do its job in a minute. Oh, my God. There's a lot of bat wings. While I'm at it, I think we're going to need to make some... Jesus, give this guy an answer. Oh, my God. We're going to need to make ourselves some more barrels. I might just do that between episodes because it's going to take a while. So let's just get rid of this stuff during here. Let's see how this is doing. It is now getting rid of bows. Should be. He did get rid of all the bows. Beautiful. I want you to get rid of... You can get rid of iron shovels. You can get rid of... helmets. Yeah, I want to get the enchanted stuff. So I want to make... I want to see if this gets rid of the enchanted stuff. So let's get you out. Let's... grab the filter. Open that up. There. And put you... like this. Put the transfer power up there. Get out of my way, then, you piece of poo. Put you there. And you should pull out the helmets, but not the, enchanted ones, I think. Yeah, it doesn't look like you are, which is good. What else do you want to be tucked away? These bows and everything are useful, but again, they are literally trashing the chest. I'm thinking that my string that might be full. No, you're not. So why are you not extracting my string? You should be extracting that a lot quicker than you're doing, because you have literally got so many items... It's painful to watch. Let's take out all of these guys, the enchanted crap for the minute, and put you all in this chest. Because clearly that's what's causing the problem. Clearly it built up so much stuff while I wasn't paying attention to it that it's going to take an absolute year for it to chuck all the stuff out. Which is fine. Let's put you all in there, pretty much. And that should be decent, I guess. You are... insane how much stuff there is here. Oh dear. We might have to go on to peaceful for the first time in this pack just to literally get rid of all the items there. And that should hopefully get rid of it all, in theory. I don't want the bow to go. I don't want the helmet to go. It doesn't look like it is, which is brilliant, so we're going to get that out and just hold on to it, I guess you could say. Oh my God! That was an insane amount of items. Look how much items there are. My God. I'm going to go make some chests. Some storage chest drawer bobbly bobs. And I'll be back in a second. Okay, so a bunch more storage drawers later. We are back over at my favourite place in the game, of course. We wanted to have a look at this. Didn't we? Or did we not? We did. Right. Batwing seems like they're a problem. So... what I want to do, let's get a batwing out. Let's get a stack of them out, because of course, batwings are my friend. Beautiful. So, let's get a chest and put one of you up on there. And put one of you in there. Beautiful. And then what I wanted to do is, again, get my quantify key and my lock key. Quantify. Lock yourself. I wanted to see if these things could be clever and only extract what can go in there. That's what I wanted to see. Are you going to extract anything that can go? You are. You look like you are actually being clever and only extracting the stuff that can go in the chest. Which is beautiful because it does mean we do not need these item filters. Which makes me one very happy person. So now you should get rid of all your junk pretty much. And my inventory is full of junk at the same time. So what I'm going to do, I'm actually going to void some items for the first time in ages. I've never done that before. But it's going to happen. I'm afraid. It's hit rock bottom, guys. It's hit the point where I'm voiding items. Oh, we're actually getting somewhere. Look at that, the batwing. The number of batwings are going down. Good. This is a good sign. We are slowly getting rid of all the items, which is beautiful. Looks like we want to add helmet and leggings and boots, which don't look like they're in the filter, this filter guy at the moment, which is, of course, fine. So let's... God, try and do one at a time, I tell you. Ugh, dear God. Boiled egg... there's some stuff in there that's just completely pointless. Chain helmet and golden leg. They're just going to have to go in there for a minute. They're just going to have to. So I want to get rid of all of this. I'm going to give this stuff a little bit of a sort out. I'll be back. Okay, welcome back. So I've saved a bunch of enchanted stuff that I want. I'm going to turn on all dictionary. And I'm going to actually ignore all dictionary and ignore MBT and ignore metadata. And I'm thinking that should delete like everything of this type. So I want match all dictionary. And that should delete all swords, all of, you know, the other stuff. You know, it should delete just a bunch of stuff, really. Cobwebs are obviously in my delete thing. Beautiful. They're going to get completely removed out of the world, which is great. And this should be chucking away... I thought it would chuck away a big bunch of stuff. Right. We're going to want to change some stuff. We're going to want to get you out. Again! Alright, boots. There should be a bow in here, so I don't know why you're not sucking up the bow, because you should be chucking away the bow no matter what, really. Let's get then... this is going to be painful, isn't it? Eh, God, any single armor type I'm going to need to sort out. How can we sort this out? So, ignore MT. The metadata is like the durability. Ignore MBT. And match all dictionary. So it should just chuck away any piece of armor in all theory. That's what it should be doing. Ignore MBT, match MBT. If we just did that, what would that? How would that do for me? Would that work? Let's get you and have a quick check. Oh, it looks like it might be dumping a load of stuff. It's dumping all these at the moment, so let's see if after that it does these. I'd like it to get rid of them, because I don't want them. Unbreaking, I will take that, though. Power, I don't know if I have power yet, so I'll probably take you as well. Beautiful. And come on, get rid of the cobwebs. Jesus, they take ages to get rid of. We're gonna see them go bye-byes or what? What's happening here? Are you gonna get rid of you gobbles? The coal's going. I don't know where the coal's going. Is it going? It's going. You're going down. You are going down. Are you sorting out coal? If I put coal in one of these, this thing is confusing the jazz out of me. I'm definitely losing coal here. Like, no doubt, no joke, I'm losing coal. This thing is awkward. Let me get this sorted. I'll be back. Okay, welcome back. So at the time of doing this, I can't think of any way to get rid of anything else like this. So pretty much just going to have to sort it out manually. Which is alright. But anyway, for the time being, I will sort out the chests, you know, off camera sometime. But let's actually get the part of this system that I wanted to get up today. So what we're going to do is we're going to go back inside. Of course, I broke that, which was not the right block to break naturally. Let's get the cobblestone back. Get the punji sticks. Hello, punji sticks. Let's go into... let's get out because we need to get the stuff on the... Get off, you piece of poo. The stuff in the inventory that I wanted. I want... Oh, God. You on my inventory hotbar. I didn't want to throw my pipes out. Why does this game do stupid stuff? Ugh. Right. Holding shift. Let's do this. Beautiful. Now let's get out. Without getting killed. Thank you. Okay, so what I actually wanted to do is break this block here. I'll show you why. So let's put these pillars back here. Let's break this block. And what we're going to want to put there is an XP vacuum. Now, you will say it needs to be activated with liquid XP. Now, how are we going to do that? So we're going to put this guy down. We have 61 levels, as you can see, so it's fine. Let's store all player XP. And what we want to do is we want to put a tank there. And we want to go to configure IO and go not pull there. That's not what I wanted. You want to... Actually, we are going to need to pull from the top because the chest's on top of it anyway. So pull from there and it will pull from... no, that's completely the wrong size. I'm an idiot. You can even see on the overlay. What's wrong with me? You're going to want to pull from here. Of course, it pulls from the XP vacuum. And we want to push just for a minute to there. We want to get our buckets out. One of you will do. And let's grab a bucket of liquid XP. And now that thing is activated, we can go back onto here. And we can stop pushing. We can go pull, actually. And it will pull all the XP that was back in there back into the tank. Did I actually put it on top? I did, because this UI is completely rubbish. Pull. And pull that. It will pull all that back in. which would be good. And now this guy's activated. So wait, if we wait 2 seconds, and well, that's drawn all this crap out. Beautiful. We can break this, or we can leave it there. It's completely up to you. I'm going to break it, and I'm also going to go back onto IO and get rid of that. Now, if we turn on the mob farm, so we actually put it back onto hard mode, for instance, and we take all of our XP there. There is zero XP in there, okay? Now, if we go all the way over here, of course those mobs are going to drop XP now. Well, they dropped XP before, but that's not the point. So now when they get killed, which we are obviously, is happening right now anyway, if we run over there, it's been a little short time, you see, so probably not very many have died. If you now run over there, you'll see in here, 13 experience already. See how quickly that thing gains XP. We've literally got an infinite XP farm. It's absolutely insane. So, that's pretty much been this episode. But what I'm going to use this XP for, I think we're going to do one last thing. What we're going to use this XP for is we're going to want to make a enchanter. In fact, I want to keep that thing I had there. I want to keep those upgrades there. But, enchanter is made like so. Now, it is from Ender Isle. It's made 4 dark steel and 2 diamonds as a book and some obsidian, I think. No, 2 diamonds, a book, 4 dark steel. That's it. 2 diamonds, a book, which we can make with... we can make like this. Boom, boom. Boom, boom. Let's get some paper. We have some in here we should have. 1, 2, 3. We do. Beautiful. There we go. That's not how you make a book. It's made, what is it then? Like this, maybe? Oh, Jesus. A book. How do you make a book? String. There we go. Alright. Paper, patterns. Book, we need 4 dark steel, which is obsidian, silicon, and iron? No. Iron, coal dust, obsidian. Almost got it right. Iron, coal dust, we need coal. I've also had to compress some of these blocks because I had so many of them. And obsidian, which I have an auto obsidian thing being made here, by the way. So it's automatically making obsidian, which is insane. Beautiful. Then we just need to go boom. That should process through. We should smash some stuff up there. How are you doing on lava? You've probably got none in you, which is fine. That's absolutely, it doesn't bother me, it's fine. Okay, obsidian, so we're going to want to go boom, boom, and boom. I'm going to wait till this is done, I will be back. Okay, with our dark still done, all we need to do is go like this. I'm sorry if you can hear us laughing in the background, that'd be my mum, hysterical person. Enchanter. And then what we can go and do, we can put it anywhere, but I'm going to put it over here because I'm an absolute legend and it goes next to this guy anyway. Let's pull the loot bags into there, make sure they're all going into there. And we can stick the enchanter here. There's a load of items in the mob thing already. So that's not a good sign. Peaceful. Full up of armor. Again. Beautiful. We're gonna have to get this sorted. But for the time being, this guy, as you can see, is getting an absolute arsenal of XP. Now, if we go into here, I don't know if we can see recipes. Show recipes. You can make enchanted books. Now, what I want to do is enchant my... what are they called? The blimmin' stiff netting stuff, sieving thing, mabobbly bob, what's it called? There. We can enchant the meshes, so you can put fortune on them, I don't know what else you can put on them, and they can obviously give you better drops. So that's pretty much what I want to do, and then soon we are going to be automating the sieves, but that has been it for this episode. If you have enjoyed, make sure you hit the like button and subscribe for more awesome content like this on FTB Sky Factory 3, and of course on FTB Beyond, and also a new pack that is coming out called... I can't remember what it's called. It's a really good mod pack. It's a new HKM mod pack. It's coming out. If you don't know, a YouTuber called Darktosis or something. Anyway, he makes the pack. I'll have information about it when it comes out. It should be coming out in the next few days. It's going to be really awesome. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you later. Goodbye. Check out all my other series.